recording, and hello everyone. And I've got this wonderful piece of art in my hand, which I'm showing off with great pride. And this art piece is by our guest today. So first of all, a welcome to my talk show, Dr. Suhani Kisang, Arts or Culture Ka Sangam, in collaboration with Brand Hue here. They say, you know, when an art piece is done, you can see it, right? Yes, it's right here in front of me. I was one of the lucky ones to get this as a surprise. And I'd come home one fine day, very tired from work. And I had this beautiful artwork kept on my table in this wonderful box. And when I opened it, I said, wow, I actually felt completely refreshed. So without much ado, let's welcome the artist of this wonderful artwork. Yeah, now I guess you all can see. Yeah, wonderful artwork. That's none other than Raina Ashar. Let's give her a big round of applause.
Hello, hello. Thank you so much. For
It's absolutely my pleasure to have you on my talk show, Dr. Suhani Kisang, Arts or Culture Ka Sangam. Well, Raina, as you all know who have joined, is just all of 13 years old, a grade 8 student. She goes to the school Rustam Ji, right, Raina? Rustam Ji, Cambridge International School. I have to share it with you all, you know. We were exchanging messages and I sent her the spelling of Rustam Ji and she immediately corrected with me and she said, it's not double I, it's double E, Rustam Ji with double E. So that's completely amazing. It's so great to have you on my talk show today. So Raina is a wonderful artist and she is into doing various kinds of techniques, so right from fluid art to canvas, you know, acrylics on canvas. And she's got two more new kind of techniques that she does. And she's going to soon tell us all about it. Well, it is, it's called resin art. And it's also, there's something called alcohol ink art. Okay. So Raina, tell us, how did this all start for you?
So art is something that I have always, always loved. And art has always been very close to my heart. So even in school from third, fourth standard, I have in arts, I have always scored like A+. And last year when lockdown and COVID happened, I dedicated a lot of time to art. And that's when my love for art grew even more. So canvas creations by Raina started last year, like in 2020. During Diwali, after Diwali actually, and that's when I actually started to, you know, sell my artworks, sell coasters, bookmarks, like everything original. So yeah, that's where everything started from.
So Raina, just ever since Diwali, that's just a few months old, your Insta page, you know, Canvas Creations by Raina is absolutely rocking. Guys, I hope you all are hearing. You'll have to go to this page, Canvas Creations by Raina, canvas with a K, mind you. And you have to just see to believe. Once you see, then you will also like and you will immediately order for all her artwork, the beautiful artwork that she does, right? So brilliant stuff she has. So Raina, tell us of the, you know, the artworks that you create of these different techniques.
So I'm mainly into abstract and acrylics. So for acrylics, I do a lot of canvas painting. And canvas painting mainly into like florals and everything more related to green. So for canvas painting, this is something I had made. Okay.
Right.
This is made out of acrylics, fine acrylics. I've used Monmouth fine acrylics for this. This is also something that I really enjoy because it's a lot floral based and I love flowers. yeah. Then I also love doing fluid art. And fluid art is something that I really enjoy. So fluid art, they say, is a therapeutic form of art. And fluid art is basically you're just pouring colors. And even if you're not an artist and you have zero art experience, still you will really like your output because the colors find their own way and you don't actually do much into it. So fluid art also has a lot of different techniques. Like every day you scroll through Instagram or YouTube or any, you know, social media platform, various people will have various kinds of techniques, and all techniques give very, very beautiful outputs. So I also do teach fluid art, and I sell fluid art kits. So there are, like, I have numerous students who have zero art experience but have made beautiful artworks. So that's the specialty of fluid art. Then I do is alcohol inks. So alcohol inks is something which people have not heard of or is not really, really famous. But alcohol inks is basically you use inks and you use alcohol. That's your chemistry lab, the 99% isopropyl alcohol. And then using a hair dryer, you just randomly, you know, put it on the inks and the inks will flow. And that's how it's created. So I don't know if you can see.
Yes, I can see. It's beautiful, Raina.
And then I also do resin. So I mainly create coasters, and this is something I launched today. So for you know, like mainly for Valentine's and because it's a heart love.
So
this is actually, I use it as a photo frame. I've put three photos, and I've poured resin, the chemical, over it using gold pigment, and this is also something
it's really so beautiful. It's so beautiful. It's wonderful. And we are very, very lucky that on a talk show you said that, you know, you launched this today. So all you wonderful people who are watching us, who are here with us, Raina has launched Raisin Art Works today. And please do go and see her Insta page, and you will see a wonderful stuff that's done by her. And with Valentine's Day around the corner, guys, what you waiting for? Go ahead and just click. That's it. You can just do click and you will get your wonderful raisin art for you, right? That's great.
Yes, thank you.
So, Raina, tell us, Who's do you get this creativity from? Your mom or your dad or from
who? So I don't know. Like, frankly speaking, my dad, he does not do art, and he cannot do art. And mama is also not into art. But I guess there is somewhere they must be having creativity which they are not showing. And I have been pushing that, please do this with me one day. So. Like that will not happen, but I will make sure that day happens. So I don't know if it has come from mama, but I guess the entrepreneurship has come from them. Both of them have given me good skills before I started. You know, they told me like your profit, you know, loss, and we've also learned it in school, but you know, like having proper margins and writing your costs every day or writing your monthly cost and then finding out. So all of this mama and papa have taught, and they helped me, you know, also in, if I have to launch something new and I'm very confused on what should be the pricing, that's when also mama and papa help. So
I am really looking forward to the day when Raina says that, okay, now my ma and my pa have joined me for this artwork, and this is a joint creation by three of us.
I'm eagerly waiting.
amazing. So Raina, you're all of 13 grade 8 students, you're an artist, and you're an entrepreneur too. How does that feel? You know,
I feel very, very happy. I feel very proud of myself that I'm able to manage school and studies and my art, my passion, everything together. And it's not like that, you know, I'm behind in something. I feel that everything is going hand in hand and everything is going well for now. So I feel very, very proud of myself that I'm able to do everything together.
And we are extremely proud of you. Kudos to you, Raina Ashar. Amazing stuff. Amazing stuff. Well, as we were talking, you know, and you, there's so many newer techniques, and of course you're on Instagram, you know, so there are, Insta is filled with such wonderful artists, you know, there are so many creative artists out there. So who's the artist that Raina Ashar follows?
So I follow two main inspirations. They're my inspiration. One is someone called Shruti Karthike. So I have told like all my friends, go follow her. She's very good and she's, you know, very, very nice with her work. And that's where the florals and the canvas, like the painting I sent, wildflowers, like the basic concept has been inspired from her. And she's very, very good with her work. Like even her background is so beautiful. Like she showed different techniques on even how to blend and make a good background. And for raising alcohol inks and fluid art, there's someone called Sakshi Lunkar. Her Insta handle is Sakshi Lunkar Art. She is also very good with her work. Like she's made like huge alcohol ink artworks, like about 36 inch ones. And they are very, very beautiful. So that's somewhere like she's my inspiration in based of even her whole company, how she handles. Like she sells. Her workshops have around 25 to 30 students every Sunday that happen. So that is also, you know, something that I really want to learn from. And hopefully when I turn her age, I wish to have like around 50 students every Sunday. That's where my
I'm sure you're gonna have it. I can just see that. Your parents must be thoroughly, thoroughly elated and proud, and they must be feeling amazing that their wonderful daughter is really, really doing so well. And it's not the question, you know, Raina, it's not the question, you know, about, you know, doing well or whatever. It's just a question of independence, you know. What you are doing is at your age, at the age of 13, you know, you are absolutely independent. You're actually getting financially independent too because you started your own business, you know. I think that's amazing. It must be such a great feeling, right, to do something on your own. So tell us, Raina, you know, of course, the wonderful art that you do, the creativity that you do. And I, when we were having a conversation, you were also telling me that you were teaching art, you know. So can you tell us about it, please?
So when lockdown started, after a month, I started having these free Zen doodle and Zentangle workshops, which I used to do like one art class where I used to teach them an artwork on an A5 size and A5 size sheet. And that's what I used to do. And right now also, I sell kits. And with the kits, I have a 2.5 hour session where I teach them various techniques of fluid art if they opt for a fluid art kit. And if they opt for an alcohol ink kit, I teach them how to make a proper alcohol ink clock so that they can hang it up on their wall.
That's brilliant.
And I also love teaching and I love talking and I love interacting with people. So that's where I guess also that helped me while I was teaching.
Excellent. Fantastic. Simply super, Raina. Raina, what do you see yourself, you know, in the near future? You know, do you want to be of like a full-fledged artist? Do you, this is what you want to take up in the near future?
Yes. So, like for getting a degree, if I'm talking about, then I want to do Master in Fine Arts and Commercial Arts. Yeah. That's what I want to do. And after I do that, yes, I want canvas creations by Raina. I want to do full time. I want to dedicate 24/7, 365 days in a year, everything two canvas creations by Raina, and like canvas creations by Raina like should be a big brand, hopefully. you know, till then I turn 30, and yeah, that's what my goal is.
Wow. Excellent. Wow. It's amazing, you know, how a young teenage we have out here, and she's already seeing, she's so focused, she knows what her future is. So again, a big round of applause for you, Raina Ashar. Great to know you and great to have you on my talk show. So tell us, Raina, a little more about yourself. You know, at what age did you first start, you know, doodling around?
So doodling has always been like third standard. My late school notebooks, everything. I used to do like those small kawaii doodles and flowers I used to do. And I used to do like small pencil shading at the back of every book I could find. And then, yeah, same story that after that, slowly, my hands grew of practice of just drawing flowers at behind of the book, and here I am right now. Well, I can call myself that. Yes, I'm an artist. So
super. Okay, so what is it that Raina likes to do besides art, besides creativity? What are your other hobbies, Raina?
I love dancing. I immensely love dancing. I I've learned Kathak for 4.5 years. I've learned Kathak, and I wish to learn pole dancing in the future. I mean, after 2 years. So yeah.
Wow, that's really brilliant. Even I love dancing. I think that's something which takes me to another world when I start, you know, dancing, you know. That's wonderful, Raina. We have a whole lot of people. You've got a huge fan following. I can see so many people have joined our talk show today. So please say a big, quick hello to everyone.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining. It means a lot.
Yeah. So, Raina, we have like... from, of course, Bhavi Story, Dishi Bajaj, Khushbu, Sudhir, Komal, Meenal. Then there's Disha Bajaj, there's Mehul Javeri, Lata Samani, Ami Pranav, there are Trisha Javeri. Thank you so much for joining us for this wonderful episode with the one and only Raina Ashar. So Raina, there's a quick question that you know, it's come from the from one of our guests. You know, of course, you know, you said that your parents helped you out when you were kind of, you know, making your page, and where the business aspect of it was concerned, you know. So any kind of goal you have that, no, this is what you must reach, a business, a proper goal where, you know, that, okay, I must sell so many artworks of mine, anything like that, or you just going with the flow?
So currently I have a goal that at least in 2021 I should do more than 50 sales at least. That's what my goal is. It's like, for me, it's a very huge goal, but I am working hard towards it. I can reach 50 sales in 2021 should be my goal currently. And do more international. So I receive like two to three orders internationally. And hopefully more of international, because I did 2020, like from November to December. I started in November. So in those 2 months, I did even sell to Tamil Nadu and Hyderabad and all those places. Mm-hmm. But now I feel 2021, I should also explore, like I should get orders internationally. So I get more, I can sell more, and that's what I currently
So Mehul Javedi, I hope your question is answered. That was the question on your behalf. And we have Raina's super dad join us, who's Dr. Neil Ashar. And he's saying, super proud of you. How sweet. Well, so Raina, this is one thing I really wanted to ask you, you know. when you launched your Insta page, Insta is a very, very young and youth-oriented, you know, platform. And of course, thanks to the pandemic, the whole world has moved online, you know. So a lot of people have got online and, you know, they're doing a lot of things online and all. So what is it, what is the reaction of all your, you know, your friends and from school and your friends all over, your cousins, your relatives, what did they think that, you know, wow, Raina has, you know, created her own page now and she's going to sell her art. So what was it that their reaction?
All my friends are very happy. I received a lot of funny reactions. Tu mujhe bana ke degi, like so friends, all that stuff. And last week I fourth standard, I had a very, very good friend who I lost in touch with, and after you put out the reel and I shared it, she replied to the story, super proud of you, and it's been long, we haven't talked. So yeah, there are a lot of, you know, things people have, again, like through art, I feel, I also, whom I had lost connection with, they've come back, and there is a lot of different, you know, so my friends had reacted like very distinct, calm and nice. They're like, yeah, you will be able to do it, all of them supported. So everyone was very happy.
That's wonderful. Raina, what do you feel, you know, like when the canvas is in front of you and, you know, you start with your painting or you start with your drawing, what is that feeling that goes on within you, you know?
So if it's always different, okay? Every time I start with, it's always different. If I'm doing flow art, I am always into that zone where if it's an order, I'm always into that. Because it's abstract, the paints carry it, the paints make its own path, and I don't know how the output is going to be. And so I'm always somewhere or the other back in my head, I'm like, this should come out, dude, this should come out. It always changes how the paints flow. So I'm always like, you know, it should come out good, this should come out fine. And if it's not in order, if I'm doing fluid art, like generally, I am always I'm always, when I look at it, there was a huge canvas I made for home, for my house and for the balcony. If I'm posting it on Instagram, I always say to inclinees, she is my reflection and I am hers. So it's always like I see myself in every artwork, in every aspect.
Guys, isn't that beautiful? Oh my god, that's really, really wonderful, Raina. It's like you've completely touched me with all the things that you've said. It's lovely, you know, of how you feel about each of your work, of how you get lost in each of your work, and it's totally wonderful. Wow, that's great. So so Raina, of course, online is the way forward, as we can see, and you know, everybody being online thanks to the pandemic, as I said, as I mentioned before. But in future, would you like to have a live show, you know, at an art gallery or just, you know, at a banquet hall? Would you like to do that?
Yes, I would love to do that. So in the future, yes, I would do. I would love to have like live sessions where I'm teaching, or I would love to have live sessions where I'm showing my work and people are purchasing or something like that. And in the future, I also wish to have my own art studio. So that I want to do, like after 10th or after 12th, probably I would love to have my own space, because I have made the house very, very.
Yeah, how sweet is that? That's wonderful. You can see that in the near future, we can see Raina Ashar in her own studio coming on our talk show all over again very, very soon. So all our best wishes to you, Raina, for all your future endeavors. And it's really, really been wonderful talking to you. I can't believe time has flown by. It's just gone zoom, because we were so engrossed in listening to the wonderful things that Raina Ashar had to share with us. And yes, guys, her Insta page is Canvas Creations by Raina, Canvas with a K. Do go and check it out. And believe me, you are going to click and order one or some of her stuff because it is so very beautiful. Well, we have got Mehul Javeri saying, would love to see you making a small documentary of your work in COVID times, and it inspires everyone. How sweet is that? Raina, I think that's a brilliant idea. In fact, Mehul, you took away what I was going to say. I would love to see that. It would be really, really wonderful. Because when you, right? What do you say, Raina?
Yes, I shall start working on it like right now.
Raina, it was so wonderful. Once again, it's I've got the opportunity of to thank you for the wonderful, wonderful, surprise that you sent to me, and the lovely, as you all can see, these beautiful bookmarks. These are all made by Raina. And when we opened the show, I showed you the beautiful creative artwork that she had done. And without much ado, let's wish Raina a great success in all that she does.
Thank you.
You're more than welcome. In each and every of my episode, before we go, I always say, stay safe and be positive. And all you wonderful people out there, if there is anything that is worrying you or troubling you, don't keep it within yourself, bottled up within yourself. Kindly communicate it with a friend who you trust, or with a family member, or with your inner circle. But do communicate it, do talk about it, because by keeping it bottled up, it's only going to harm your health. If you share it, you never know, somebody else may be facing the same problem, and you can help that person out too. And yes, it's a genuine request. Please look after your health, because if you are well, you can look after your families too. So do that to yourself. And on this note, before we leave, Raina, would you like to say anything to our viewers before we leave?
One, thank you so much for having me on the show. It means a lot. Like, I cannot tell you how much it means. It's like dream come true kind of feeling. Like someone's asking questions and I'm answering. Also, I just started like Canvas Creations, so it means a lot. And to the viewers, thank you so much for joining in. And it means a lot. It means the world. It means everything, because you all joined in. It was so much fun. Thank you so much.
So guys, do go on Raina Ashar's Insta page, Canvas Creations by Raina with a K. And yes, do go and check that out. And I would urge you to go on my YouTube channel. That's Dr. Suhani Mendonca. Please do like, share, subscribe, and yes, comment, because your feedback is indeed very valuable for us. So on this note, bye-bye, everybody. God bless you. Have a great weekend ahead, because today is Thursday, tomorrow is Friday, and the weekend starts, right? Tomorrow. So have a great time ahead. Bye-bye from me, Dr. Suhani Mendonca, and Raina Ashar.
Bye-bye.
God bless.